From DocuSign, I'm Mei Shea, a member of the Developer Center team. In this screencast, I'll walk through installing and running the Java Quick Start and the embedded signing code example. The prerequisite to this video is an unzipped Quick Start zip file. If you haven't yet downloaded your Java Quick Start, please first follow the steps in the Quick Start overview page or the How to Download Quick Start video. Quick Start is a software wizard that packages a personalized code example launcher. You can choose from 8 programming languages. The Quick Start wizard configures an app in the developer's DocuSign account that can make API calls. These steps are completed for the developer. The launcher is downloaded from GitHub. An integration key is created in the developer's account. A secret key is created to enable authorization code grant. An RSA key is created to enable JWT grant. Redirection URLs are added, and the configuration file is modified with the developer's personalized information. To run the Java Quick Start launcher, I must have the Java prerequisite software installed. This list of prerequisites can be found in the README file located in my unzipped Quick Start file, which I've named Tally Customer Portal. This README is also available on our GitHub page at github.com/docusign/code-examples-java. The README file has a description of all the API code examples with their source links to GitHub. I'll scroll to the installation prerequisites section. It says, note, if you downloaded this code using Quick Start from the DocuSign Developer Center, skip steps 1 and 2 below as they're automatically performed for you. The Java prerequisites are steps 3 and 4 because Quick Start takes care of step 5 by pre-populating my developer account information, which I'll show later. In order to install and run the Java launcher, I'll need JDK 11 or later and Maven. I can follow the links to download the applications. Since I'm using the IntelliJ Ultimate IDE, I'll scroll to the IntelliJ Ultimate instructions in the README file. There are also instructions for Eclipse IDE. In the first sentence, there's a link to download IntelliJ Ultimate IDE. Next, it says, note, if you downloaded this code using Quick Start from the DocuSign Developer Center, skip step 1 as it was automatically performed for you. Since I've downloaded the Quick Start, I will go directly to step 2. Step 2. Start IntelliJ Ultimate and choose the Open or Import option. Step 3. Use the pop-up file chooser to select Code Examples Java or your unzipped Quick Start directory. I'll select Tally Customer Portal, the name of my unzipped Quick Start directory. Step 4. Click OK and the project will be displayed in the IDE. Per instructions, I'll click OK. Now on the README, I'm in Configuring IntelliJ's Run Debug Configuration. Step 1. Use the menu command Run Edit Configurations to open the Configuration Manager. Step 2. Under Templates in the left sidebar, select Spring Boot. Step 3. Update the form with the name of the configuration to Code Examples Java and the main class for the configuration com.docusign.app. Tip. Use the ellipsis button next to the field to choose the main class. Under Spring Boot, select the Enable Debug Output checkbox. In the project window, I see the folder structure of the unzipped file. Quick Start enables developers to quickly run DocuSign code examples by configuring a launcher with the developer's account information. For the Java launcher, this configuration file is located in the Source Main Resources folder and is named application.json. Aside from my email address and name, my unique client ID, client secret, and impersonated user ID are also displayed in the configuration file. In my DocuSign developer account, the client ID is called the integration key. Client ID is the standard OAuth term, integration key is a DocuSign term. Since it contains personal information, please don't store this application.json file in your source control. I can also view and modify the source files in the project window and see my changes when running that code example. The Java Quick Start Launcher will directly open the embedded signing code example page, which I'll show later. Here's the code for embedded signing in the source main java.com.docusign folder. The file name is eg001 controller embedded signing. I will change the name of the file from lorem ipsum to hello world. This name will be shown when the document is presented in the browser. I use Ctrl S to save my changes. Now I'm in the running or debugging the launcher section. Use a run menu option to run or debug the launcher. From the menu, I'll select run, then run code examples Java. After the application finishes building, open your browser to http://localhost:8080. I authenticate with my developer account credentials. I see the consent window from the application Tally Customer Portal. In the authorization code grant flow, the application obtains consent from the individual user to perform actions on their behalf, then receives an authorization code that can be exchanged for an access token, which is required to make API calls. Once the user has granted consent to an application, they will not be prompted again unless consent is revoked. I click Accept. Next, I see the embedded signing code example. All quick starts are pre-configured to run this code example. Embedded signing demonstrates how to collect signatures directly within my app without emailing the signer. Also linked are the API methods used, envelopesCreate and envelopeViewsCreateRecipient. The links will take me to the Developer Center pages that describe those methods. The link to the source file will show me the code for embedded signing in GitHub. Now the signer email and name have been pre-populated with my developer account information. I can change the signer email and name. I click Submit to send the envelope. I'm taken directly to the document. Now I scroll to the bottom of the document and see that the document name is no longer Lorem Ipsum, but has been changed to Hello World per my modification. I'm going to sign the document and click Finish. I'm taken to the Signing Complete page. I click Continue. Now I see the Java Launcher homepage with all the code examples. I can run the other code examples as well. All these code examples are also available in the other Quick Start launchers: Bash, C#, Node.js, PHP, PowerShell, Python, and Ruby. If you have any questions about how to develop your integration with DocuSign, here are some resources. I recommend checking out the Developer Center how-to guides, going to Stack Overflow, reaching out to support, or signing up for API office hours. That's it. Thanks for tuning in. Please send questions and comments to developers@docusign.com.